Hi friends, myself Darshana Savla here on behalf of Dress My Craft, and today I will be giving you all a basic brief introduction to the newly launched product at Creativation 2020, and that is Shrink Prink Frosted Glass Sheets. So as you see, the Shrink Prink Frosted Glass Sheets come in a pack of A4 size. So this is available in a pack of 10 sheets. It is available in a pack of 50 sheets. It is also available in a pack of 100 sheets. And you can see the beautiful creations that you can make out of this. You can make your tiaras, you can make your finger rings, you can make your small brooch pins, you can make your hair clips, you can make your hair pins, and it is endless. You can create beautiful jewelry from this. You can create your earrings, your pendants, your necklaces. You can also create your keychain bunches for your purses. You can also create it for your any kind of embellishments for your scrapbooking, and you know, this is endless. So let's get started with all the basic tips, tricks and techniques about Shrink Prink Frosted Glass Sheets. To begin with, let me brief you all a little bit more about what is Shrink Prink Frosted Glass Sheets. So the Shrink Prink Frosted Glass Sheets are, this is glossy on the one side and this is frosted on the other side. So you can use both the sides for your working. You can either use the frosted finish or you can use the glossy finish. So you can also die cut it. So we have loads of die cuts here. As you see, these are various dies from Dress My Craft, and we have done loads of die cutting, and it is very simple and super easy to die cut, and these are versatile for any of the die cutting machines, and any of these dies will work with these kind of frosted sheets. So if you see, all the size of the dies are much bigger compared to the normal regular size. The reason being, we are going to heat it. So once you heat the Shrink Prink Frosted Glass Sheets, they shrink. So we need a bigger size of dies, and the Dress My Craft dies are absolutely apt for this kind of work, and you have like enormous sizes in a very many of these packs. So first of all, let me show you all how to go about further after the die cutting. So once we have finished with the die cutting, the second option is also that you can have your own hand-drawn template, and you can simply place this template on the frosted side, and with the help of the watercolor pencils, you can trace it out. So you can place your template, you can trace it out, here, and then you can hand cut it. So you can use, I am using the mini snips by tin holes. You can use any scissor, but I find this one of the best ones to do this kind of cutting. So you can hand cut it along the edge of the tracing line, and it is super easy to cut without any difficulty, without any extra effort. You can create wonderful shapes with this. In case if you have a die, you can use your die also as a template, and you can trace it. So you can use any kind of stencils or any kind of objects that you know attract you to create beautiful shapes from Shrink Prink Frosted Sheet. So to repeat, you can die cut them using any die cutting machines. You can use any dies with it. You can also, you know, trace them with the help of any templates that you have, and you can also place your dies and you can trace on it. You can also print on them with any inkjet printers, and it can be printed on both the sides. You can also stamp them with stazons, archival inks and any permanent inks, so they become permanent on both the sides. So this is the best part about the Shrink Prink Frosted Sheets, is there are so many possibilities of using it on both the sides. After we finish with this step, we move on to the coloring step. So talking about the colors, there are various color mediums that can be used, as the Shrink Prink Frosted Glass Sheets are glossy on one side and frosted on one side. You can use various color mediums. So you can use your Sharpies. Sharpies can be used with the brush tip ones or the fine tip ones. And both these Sharpies can be used either on the frosted side and on the glossy side, because they both are permanent pens. So this is wonderful. You can also use your Copics. Copics are also once again permanent, so Copics also can be used on both the sides. Then we have the color pencils. So the best part about the color pencils is they can be used on the frosted side and you can create wonderful colors and wonderful shades with it. It's very interesting. It's so exciting and nothing less. But then you can also use your Krylon pens. These Krylon pens are silver, golden and copper. They can also be used to create wonderful outlines, wonderful edgings. You can also be using your permanent markers. These are white permanent markers. You can also use your black permanent markers and you can doodle your own sketches that you wish to on this. So let me show you all a little bit first, starting with the Sharpies. So let me grab some nice color for this. So let me take some yellow and let me take some orange for this. So if I have to take the brush tip Sharpies, I will pick up one die cut out from here and I'll be showing you coloring on the frosted side. So you can give a single color application on the frosted side with the brush tip Sharpies, and it is so easy and so super smooth to rub around on the frosted side, making sure that you cover up all the edges, do not leave any of them. So it's very easy to color it on the frosted side. So this is single color application. To add on to this, you can also use a darker color shade and you can give, you know, tiny brush strokes from the center moving upwards just to create some dimension to the flower petals. So it is a brush tip, or you can also use a sharp tip. So we can take a sharp tip here. It's tight. And can you see? Wonderful. You can give fine thin strokes with the thin tips. So you can either use your thicker pens or you can use your sharper pens. All this I am doing is on the frosted side. Exactly the same I can do it on the shiny side, on the glossy side as well, and you will see once you heat it the results are going to vary. How they are going to vary we will see once we do the embossing to this. So once I have colored this with Sharpie, I'll show you how beautiful they look. So this is coloring on the glossy side. And once again, I take the thin Sharpie and I give strokes. So once the flower gets heated and once you takes back its place, you will see how different effects you get to see on the frosted side and the glossy side. The glossy side will appear more darker and the frosted side will appear more matte finish and more subtle. So once we finish the coloring, we will move on to the heating. To get started with the heat embossing, we need the heat embossing tool. So I'm using the Dovecraft embossing heat gun. We also need the embossing pad. So this is the soft embossing pad from Dress My Craft, and this is a heat resistant embossing pad specifically for any kind of flower embossings, any kind of floral embossings, any kind of your paper, any product will work on this. To make it more durable for the shrink print, I have covered it with a white fabric cotton sleeves. So these sleeves are there to make sure that the shrink print frosted sheets do not stick onto the foam. And the most important thing that you will require is the heat resistant tweezer. These are the ceramic tip tweezers specially designed for shrink print frosted sheets. So when you use this, it does not heat up, it does not burn your fingers. At the same time, it will help you to hold the petal in the place. Apart from all this, also we require the hand punches. Now these hand punches come in three different sizes. So we have the small size, we have the medium size, and we have the large size. So this is 1/16, this is 1/8, and this is 1/4 of the circles. So depending upon the size of the petal, we will be selecting the size of the one hole punch. So the reason being we are having three different sizes is Once you are heating the petals, they will shrink. So when they shrink, the center size of the holes also shrink, and we require these holes to pass through any kind of beads, any kind of studs or any kind of stones while creating any kind of jewelry pieces or when creating any kind of danglers. So if I have to show you all where I'm going to use the small size, if I have a small size of petal, I will be using a small size and I will punch it right in the center. Sometimes you may not be able to locate your center position, no worries. What you can do is, you can take any white color pencil or you can take any color pencil, a lighter shade, and you can just simply create a dot in the center. So this will give you a perfect positioning of the center of the petal. And you can punch it in the center. So again, I'm taking the smaller size and this gives me a perfect center positioning to this. Then if I have a bigger size of petal, so what I'll be doing is I take the medium size of the punch and you place this right in the center and you can punch it. If I have a bigger size of a petal, so for the bigger size of the petal, I will be using the bigger punch and they are super smooth, super easy and super handy to punch it. So this is how you can get various three different sizes as per the size of the petals. So if I have a smaller petal, I will use a smaller one, that is a 1/16. If I have a medium size of the petal, I will use the 1/4 one, 1/8 one. And if I have a bigger size of the petal, I will use the 1/4 one. So these are very easy, very super easy to use and very super soft. And they are a boon for any kind of scrapbooking as well, apart from shrink-proof frosted jewelry. Coming to the heating, and that is the most exciting part, and you can see the magic now. So I would show you all, this is the glossy side where I had colored the Copic. This is the matte finish where I had colored the Copic. Now I will heat set first is the glossy side where I had colored the Copic on the glossy side. I will keep the glossy side up. I will first punch the center hole in the center, so that I can use this as any kind of a dangling or a bead. And this also helps me to hold the flower in its place. Now, how much distance you are going to keep this? The heat to gun should not be too close. It should not be too far. A minimum of 6 inches of a distance is perfect for this. So hold your tweezer in the place, keeping the shiny side up, that is a glossy side up. Make sure that you are rotating your tweezer all around so that there is a uniform application of heat. And you will see the petals shaping up, the petals wobbling on its own very soon. So that is not the time when you will stop your heat gun. Let the flower petals go back to its position. That is the right time when you will be stopping your heat gun and getting ahead with the shaping. So here I stop this and you can see beautiful shape, and this is flat. So if I have to keep a petal flat, I'll keep it on a stamping block and I'll press it. This helps me make the petals absolutely flat. So can you see? You can see this is looking a little bit more shiny, a little bit more darker compared to the frosted one here. I'll place it here on the white paper so you can see the difference. Now I will heat set the one that is frosted. So on the frosted side where I have colored, still I will keep the glazy part up so that you can see the difference. Now make sure that your heat tool is not too close, it's not too far, it's at a distance of minimum 6 inches, and make sure that you're rotating all over. And can you see the petals are showing a magic, and very soon you will see this shrinks and it really turns out into a cute little tiny flower, and this looks so superb, so neat, so clean. I'll lift it with the tweezer, I'll place it here and I will press it. So you can use your acrylic blocks to make sure that the petals are flat. Within 2 to 3 seconds they harden. It hardly gives you any time, so you need to be quick. So here is the difference of the coloring. Here, these are the ones on which I have colored the same color Copic, the same color Sharpie, I'm sorry, on the glossy side, and the same color of Sharpie on the frosted side, and you can see a lot of difference. I have a few flowers made just to give you all a small more brief on this. I have used the Sharpie on the back side and the front side. So here are the different variations that you can see. Even if you color on the frosted side, you can use your glass as the final finish. Even if you color on the glassy side, you can use your matte as a finish, depending upon the look that you like. And you can see these fingerings. You can just create one simple flower and you can create a fingering. You can create one simple flower and you can create your hairpin. You can create one simple single flower and you can also create this beautiful hair combs out of it. We'll get started with the Copics. So here I have four shades of pinks. I'll take any one color, say maybe the middle shade, and I'll be using the brush tip side of the Copics. First I will be coloring on the shiny side, that is the glossy side, and give one single color coat. It gives a squeaky sound. The most important thing here is you need a craft sheet underneath. It is a thick craft sheet from Dress My Craft and it is very easy to clean and very easy to use and very easy to maintain. I'm just turning this on the frosted side, the back side, and I'll color this on the matte side a single coat. So once we finish the coloring, we will be cleaning the craft sheet with the help of the baby wipes, and that will help you remove all the stains on it. It is very easy and handy to use it. It is heat resistant craft sheet, at the same time it can be easily cleaned. So I'll be showing you all how to clean the So we take the baby wipes and you clean it. That is super easy and super clean. Now let's move on to the embossing of this. To get started with the embossing, here is the one on side which I have given a frosted color, and this is the one on which I have colored on the glossy side. So I will place my heat resistant tweezer and I will use the heat tool and I will make sure that I rotate it all around. Can you see how beautiful and how pretty it looks? You place your acrylic slab down here and place it flat on it. So this becomes amazing. Now this is the matte finish, that is a frosted side, and I'll keep the frosted side up just to show you all the difference. So you can keep either the frosted side up or you can keep the glossy side up. And you can see the magic. You'll see the petals wobbling. Initially it feels, you know, what's happening, but later we'll wait until it takes its shape. Place them right here on the acrylic block and press it. Perfect. So you can see now the difference of the two, and I'll keep it on a paper, piece of paper, and show y'all how different does it look from each other. This is the one on which I have colored on the glossy side, and this is the one which I have colored on the frosted side. If I have to turn this here, it is much way darker compared to the one which I have done on the glossy side. So here the petal was, you know, colored underneath on the glossy side, and here the petal was colored on the frosted side. So it's a little different, and you can see a very beautiful and a soft finish when you color on the glossy and actually when you see it from the frosted. So this is how the Copics work differently. Here I have a few colors with the Copics. I'll show you all. So can you see the difference of the light and the dark? Yes, this looks pretty light and this looks pretty dark. So this is how, depending upon your requirement, you can use any side of the sheets for your coloring. To get started with the watercolor pencils, I have selected my 3 to 4 shades, you know, a light pink, a middle pink, and a darker pink, whichever colors you can choose. And the color pencils are used on the frosted side. So on the frosted side, first of all, I will give one single base coat with the lighter shade. That's baby pink. So making sure that there are no spaces left in between, you give a one simple and a smooth color on the frosted side, and the frosted side will absorb all the particles of the pencil colors. So once we finish coloring on all the petals one single color coat, I will take the second shade of the pink, a little darker than the lighter pink, and I will start giving strokes. This will add some dimension to the flower petals, and it really looks very great. It gives a lot of depth to the flower petals, and with color pencils you can also give strokes from the top, you can give an outline, you can do a lot of other things with the help of the color pencils, as they have a fine tip. So it is very interesting to see how different color mediums work on both the sides of the shrink prink frosted sheets. And now I'll take a little darker shade, that is a darker pink, and I'll create beautiful veins on this. So can you see? You just create, and all the colors will reflect. Once you emboss, your entire coloring will show. Your each and every stroke that you are giving with the help of this is going to show. So make sure that you color it very neatly to get a very perfect work. Each and every mark is going to show once you are going to emboss it. So this is done only on the frosted side. And now I have to show you how to go about with the embossing. So quickly grab your embossing pad, your heat resistant tweezer. Can you see how beautiful this looks? This is, I'm showing you this from the shining side, and this was the frosted side. Now keep your heat resistant tweezer right in the center. Place, go around with your heat gun, making sure that you give uniform heat all the sides, and the petals start dancing and curling, and now you can see the magic. It's amazing. It's just superb to see how beautifully the petals go back to its shape. And what I'll do is, this time I'll use the embossing stainless steel ball tools from Dress My Craft. Depending upon the diameter of the flower, you select the embossing ball tool, press it down right on the embossing pad, and tip the petal tips, curl the petal tips. So you can see a very beautiful dimension that comes to the flower, and until and unless the petals are hot, the petals are warm, they will help you to curve it. So can you see how beautiful and how gorgeous this pretty flower looks? And you can actually see all the tiny details and all the colored strokes that I had given on it. I will give you a more closer view, and you can see how beautifully the petals look. I have one more color here. I have one more here. I have a yellow also, and I have this little darker pink also. So you can see how beautiful all of them look, and you can see the veins that are to be seen on every the each and every veins are to be seen on the frosted side. So this is how you can make beautiful flowers with the pencil colors. To get started with the soft pastel coloring, I'm using the Mungio soft pastels. I have a 48 shades pack, and let me select two shades. So first of all, I'll take a lighter pink and I'll rub the soft pastels onto my finger. This is one way of coloring it. The other way is, be careful, you can just scrap out a little color on the petals, make sure it's not too much, and you can rub it out. So when you rub it out, it becomes uniform. So you color the soft pastels on the frosted side. This is one single coat with a lighter pink. Now when I'm moving on to the dark pink, I will just pull up some streaks and I'll rub them as well. So just rub it. Make sure that it isn't too dark. Make sure it isn't too light. Once I've done this, I'll blend the colors very well. Blending the colors is very important, because once you finish it, it is going to show. All the colors are going to reflect once you finish the coloring. So I have beautiful two shades, light pink and dark pink. And now we will move on to the embossing. I'll quickly punch in the center and take your embossing pad. You can take your heat resistant tweezer, you can take your embossing gun and rotate all around. I have kept the glossy side up. And make sure that you are rotating your heat tool all over, all the sides. Amazing. So, can you see how the petals curl up and they move back to their position? I'll lift it out. I will use the stainless steel ball tools from Dress My Craft. You press this down in and curl the tips of the petals. So this will give you a very beautiful dimension to the flower. So this is how you can create very simple, elegant and classy flowers with the shrink prink frosted sheets, and they just take you seconds and they will hardly take you some minutes. Just to stop here, in case if you are not satisfied with the shape, you can reheat it. Yes, you can reheat it. It won't shrink too much. It will shrink very little, but it may not shrink too much. So you can reheat it. So what you do is move around your heat tool all around once again, and you will see the petals falling back in its shape. They once again go flat, right? It does not really shrink in this process. On the contrary, it becomes more easy for you to shape it because it will give you a longer time to shape it. At this point, it will not dry very fast. This will take some time to cool. This will give you more time to shape. So when you heat it the second time, it becomes more stretchable. It becomes more elastic. It becomes more easy for you to shape it. And that is the time when you can create your desired shape once again. And you can see how beautiful and how perfect it is. So you can reheat the shrink-prink frosted sheets. So I'll show you all how it actually looks on the white paper. Amazing. This has given a three dimension. So can you see I'm wearing this finger ring? This is also three dimensional. This is also three dimensional. So all these flowers are three dimensional. And you can see this simple basic tiara. They are just one simple single tiny flowers with a diamond stud. They all look so gorgeous. And this happens just in minutes. I have one more shade to show y'all in which I have stuck a diamond stud. I have a yellow. I also have a violet, which is actually looking like a gray somehow. And you can see a blue. And this is another shade of pink. So you can create beautiful, soft, delicate flowers by using soft pastels as well. So now all the flowers are ready. They are so cute. So this is the one with the soft pastels, this is the one with the watercolor pencils, this is the one with the Sharpies, and this is the one with the Copics. To add some more to these flowers, we will be sticking these diamond studs in the center. So you can stick the diamond studs in the center with the help of the E6000, or we have the B6000 that is available here. And you can take this diamond stud, take a little of this glue, and don't take too much, take it very little and stick it down here. Take very little of this and stick it down here. So you can either stick the diamond studs in the centers, or you can have some pearls in the center, or you can also have some flower pearls. I'll show you all what it is. So this is a pearl. I pick up the pearl, I keep very little glue at the base, and I stick it right in the center. Now for few of the other centers, you can use these flower pearls. These are snow white flower pearls from Dress My Craft. So all that we need to do is, you take the flower pearls, you place the flower in the tray, and you can stick them with the help of glossy accents. So you take some glossy accent, pour the glossy accent in the center, small bulb of glossy accents, pour in the pearls. They are mixed size snow white flower pearls, and you remove the excess. Once this is through,
we have some glue that is to be seen on this. To make sure that the glue doesn't show, we'll sprinkle a little rainbow glitter. This is a rainbow glitter from Dress My Craft. It is amazing. The best part of this glitter is it'll take the color of whichever base you sprinkle on. If the flower is pink, the glitter starts showing pink. If the flower is blue, the glitter starts showing blue. If the flower is peach, the glitter starts showing peach. So basically it adjusts itself to the basic color of the flower that is there. So this is also one beautiful way of adding flower pearls to the center of the flower. So there are various ways to make the centers. So here you can see this is a hair clip made with the soft pastel colors. Here is the fingering that has been, all the flowers have been created with the color pencils. The flowers in this hair clips have been created with the Copics. And if you see, all the flowers in this beautiful crown, they have been created with a color pencil. A color pencil outline has been given to these. So these are the different beautiful ways of creating these beautiful projects. To buy the shrink prink sheets for the Indian buyers, you all can log on to www.crafterscorner.in, and for the international buyers, you all can log on to dressmycraft.com. And I'm sure this is a total addiction. You all are going to have a great time with it. Do try your hands on this. Thanks for watching the tutorial. Thanks for being there. Thank you so much, everyone.